Now, having distinguished between what we call the death of the body and the death of the person, the question whether or not you're going to die needs to be distinguished. The question whether or not you believe you're going to die needs to be distinguished. If somebody says, you know, nobody really believes they're going to die, that could mean one of two things. They could mean nobody really believes they're going to cease to exist as a person. First possibility. Second possible claim, nobody really believes they're going to undergo the death of their bodies. Let's take these in turn. Is there any good reason to believe that we don't believe that we're going to cease to exist as a person? Well, the most common argument for this claim, I think, takes the following form. People sometimes say, since it's impossible to picture being dead, it's impossible to picture being dead. That is to say, it's impossible to picture your own being dead. You know, each one of us has to think about this from the first person perspective or something like that. Think about you're dying, you're being dead. Since that's impossible to picture, that's impossible to imagine, nobody believes in the possibility that they're going to die, that they're going to cease to exist. The idea seems to be that you can't believe in possibilities that you can't picture or imagine. Now that hypothesis, that thesis, that assumption could be challenged. I think probably we shouldn't believe the theory of belief which says that in order to believe in something, you've got to be able to picture it or believe it. But let's grant that assumption for the sake of argument. Let's suppose that in order to believe in something, you've got to be able to picture it. What then? How do we get from there to the conclusion that I can't believe that I'm going to die, I'm going to cease to exist as a person? Well, the thought, of course, is I can't picture or imagine my death. I can't picture or imagine my being dead. It's important here to draw some distinctions. I can certainly picture being ill. You know, there I am on my deathbed, dying of cancer, growing weaker and weaker. I can perhaps even picture the moment of my death. I've said goodbye to my family and friends. Everything's growing grayer and dimmer. It's growing harder and harder to concentrate. And then there is no end more. The claim, however, is not that I can't picture being ill or dying. The claim's gotta be I can't picture being dead. Well, try it. Try to picture being dead. What's it like to be dead? Sometimes people claim it's a mystery. We don't know what it's like to be dead because every time we try to imagine it, we fail. We don't do a very good job. I'm inclined to think that that way of thinking about the question is really confused. You set yourself the goal of trying to put yourself in the situation imaginatively of what it's like to be dead. So I start by trying to strip off the parts of my conscious life that I know I won't have when I'm dead. I won't hear anything. I won't see anything. I won't think anything. And you try to imagine what it's like to not think or feel or hear or see. And you don't do a very good job of it. So you throw your hands up and you say, guess I don't know what it's like. So it must be a mystery. It's not a mystery at all. Suppose I ask, what's it like to be this cell phone? The answer is, it's not like anything. Well, that doesn't mean there's something that it's like to be a cell phone, but different from being anything else. So it's not like anything else. It's a special way of feeling or experiencing. No! Cell phones don't have any experience at all. There is nothing that it's like on the inside to be a cell phone. Imagine that I try out what it's like to be my due to any failure of imagination. That's because there's nothing there to imagine or picture. Still, granted the premise, if you can't picture it or imagine it, you can't believe in it, should we conclude, therefore, that you can't believe you're going to be dead? No, we shouldn't conclude that. After all, not only is it true that you can't picture from the inside what it's like to be dead, you can't picture from the inside what it's like to be in dreamless sleep. There's nothing that it's like to be in dreamless sleep. When you're in dreamless sleep, you're not imagining or experiencing anything. Similarly, it's not possible to picture or imagine what it's like to have fainted and be completely unconscious with nothing happening cognitively. There's nothing to picture or imagine. Well, should we conclude, therefore, so nobody really believes that they're ever in dreamless sleep? Well, that would be silly. Of course you believe that at times you're in dreamless sleep. Should we say of somebody who's fainted or knows that they're subject to fainting spells, they never actually believe that they pass out? That would be silly. Of course they believe they pass out. From the mere fact that they can't picture it from the inside, it doesn't follow that nobody believes they're ever in dreamless sleep. From the mere fact that they can't picture from the inside what it's like to have fainted and not yet woken up, it doesn't mean that nobody believes that they ever faint. From the mere fact that you can't picture from the inside what it's like to be dead, it doesn't follow that nobody believes they're going to die. But didn't I start off by saying I was going to grant the person who's making this argument that in order to believe something, you've got to be able to picture it? And haven't I just said, look, you can't picture being dead? So aren't I taking it back? Since I say you can believe you're going to die, yet you can't picture it from the inside, haven't I taken back the assumption that in order to believe it, you've got to be able to picture it? Not quite. Although I am skeptical about that claim, I am going to continue giving it to the person who makes this argument, because I'm not so prepared to admit that you can't picture being dead. You can picture being dead, all right. You just can't picture it from the inside. You can picture it from the outside. I can picture being in dreamless sleep quite easily. I'm doing it right now. I've got a little mental image of my body lying in bed, asleep, dreamlessly. I can picture fainting or having fainted quite easily. Picture my body lying on the ground, unconscious.